I went ahead and quit teaching. Now, why would I make such a change just like that, where many of you only know me as a teacher inside of the classroom? Now, I made the decision to step away from the classroom for a couple of reasons. Why would a teacher quit after 14 years of being inside the classroom? The only thing that I knew how to do, the only school that I have ever taught at, the only subject that I have ever taught. Why would I make such a change to step away from the classroom? So first and foremost, I have 3 children under the age of 5. And if you've ever had children or been around some younger kids, you know that they take a lot of attention. And I mean a lot. Basically, when I get home, they want to be with me and I want to be with them. Now, the other thing, if you might not know, is that teaching takes a lot of time outside of the classroom as well. Being a math teacher, I am constantly reviewing my lessons, creating new lessons for the upcoming week, as well as grading papers. And grading papers takes a ton of time. If there's one thing I could ever outsource ever, it would be grading. But it's something that I have to do as well, because that's how I get a better understanding of my students. So in reality, the last couple years, as my children have really gotten older, it's just become too chaotic, too hectic, and too exhausting at night, with its taking care of my family and being with my children up until bedtime, and then trying to cram in and doing as much work at night. It just became too much. There's very little downtime where I could relax and rejuvenate. Also, on the weekends, once Sunday hit, all I would be thinking about was preparing for Monday. Every single Sunday, I was preparing for Monday, what is going on for that week. No matter what we had to do for that Sunday, I was always thinking about that school day. And it became just a drag, because it really took me away from focusing on my family on a Sunday and really just enjoying that time, because the stress and the struggles, the amount of prep work that I had to do to be prepared for that week is all that my brain would ever focus on. Number 2 is pretty simple. I really just got bored teaching math. You know, I've been a classroom teacher for 14 years. I've taught everything from Algebra 1 all the way up to calculus, and I've taught each of those courses multiple times. Being a math teacher with a math degree, I've always had that curiosity to learn more. Now, being a teacher has been awesome, because I have been able to deepen my understanding of mathematics. I understand the content much better because I've been a teacher for so long and had to teach these concepts over and over. There's still a little want, a little need for my own curiosity to keep on expanding, to teach other mathematics that is not within my classroom. And the problem with making a lot of videos on my channel is it was all restrictive to what I was teaching that current year. And I've been teaching the same courses over and over again, and I've basically taught everything that our school offers except for statistics, which I don't want to teach anyways, so that's cool. But I have that itch to continue my learning in mathematics, as well as to make new content. It was just too hard to be doing that while being a classroom teacher and making videos of what I was teaching that year. And the number 3 reason, which I didn't really know how to explain for the longest time, but really made sense once I was able to identify it, was I was comfortable. I was really just comfortable having the job that I had. I'd been at the same school for 14 years. It was amazing community, amazing school, amazing students, amazing colleagues, amazing administration. I had everything that a teacher could ever possibly want. So what is wrong with that? Why would I step away from something that seemed so perfect? And the answer to that is, I was comfortable. I was just set in my own terms. And what you have found, if you've ever been in this situation, you have that thirst for more challenge. I wanted to, you know, as I mentioned with my education, I wanted to continue pursuing my curiosity and education in mathematics, but I also wanted to challenge myself. And a lot with what I was doing inside the classroom was losing that challenge. I was pretty comfortable in the courses that I was teaching. I was pretty comfortable with the students that I had. And obviously COVID brought in some big new challenges, but it really wasn't the challenges of COVID that made me realize I was comfortable. It was what it did, is it exposed me that I've been, you know, following the same path over and over and over. And deep down, I really was able to reflect and realize that I wanted more. I wanted more than what being a teacher can offer me inside of the classroom. I would never take back any of the years that I was a teacher. But I realized that if I'm really going to pursue everything that I want and to be everything I want to be, I gotta step out of my comfort zone. And becoming a teacher was very comfortable for me. The reason why that makes so much sense now that I understand it is because that's exactly what I tell my students to do. To not be comfortable, to make sure that they try. A lot of times when they're working on mathematics, they don't wanna make mistakes. They don't wanna go on a limb and be exposed. They don't wanna raise their hand and ask questions in fear of being wrong. I think that's what kept me in education for a little bit longer. Even though I said I would always be a teacher as long as I had the itch to teach, which I did for every year that I was a teacher. However, you have to be willing to make mistakes, to step outside of your comfort zone. And I feel now at this time in my life, COVID has allowed me to reflect on what I really want to achieve. And that involves getting outside of the classroom walls. Now, there's a whole host of other reasons of why people think I'm stepping away from teaching, or that actually factored into my decision. But none are as important as the three that I mentioned to you. And what's even more special about stepping away from the classroom is it's given me the time not only with my family, as well as my curiosity in mathematics, but stepping away from the classroom is allowing me to put more time into this channel, put more time into creating content that I hope that you are going to enjoy, as well as that's gonna help you with your learning in mathematics. So I hope my reasons make a little sense, but maybe you've always just questioned, why would he step away from the classroom? Why do teachers quit? I hope this video put a little bit into context, and I look forward to seeing you in the next video. Cheers.